Welcome to another Shopify tutorial. And this one, we're gonna go a little bit more in depth on how to create BOGO discounts, both manual and automatic. Let's get into it. All right, so after you log into your Shopify, you wanna go to discounts. And then, as you can see here, it has both discount codes and automatic discounts, but we just wanna click on the button that says create discount. And then this will actually prompt the question whether you wanna do a discount code where customers actually have to go in and put in the code, or if you wanna create automatic discounts so the customer doesn't have to put in a code, it just automatically gets rid of that second item on their cart. So let's create our discount code. We'll click on the first one. And this one's gonna be the manual one. So I'm just gonna call it BOGO 2020, all right? When you create a discount code that customers have to actually type in, you wanna create something that's gonna be easy to remember. And usually people do all caps, just so there's no confusion between uppercase or lowercase or things like that. So Shopify does give you the ability to generate a code, but that code is gonna be a random string of letters and numbers. Probably don't want to do that for this instance. Once you create your discount code, then on their types, you want to do buy X, get Y. And then Shopify gives you a few options here. So you can either do minimum quantity of items. So maybe you have to buy two of something in order to get, so maybe two shoes in order to get a free pair of socks, for example. Or you can just leave it simple. Buy a shoe, get a free pair of socks. Or you can do a minimum purchase amount. So once you reach $20, then we send you this free koozie, for example. Now, I'm gonna leave it as minimum quantity of items. We're gonna go straight with one, and then we're gonna go with a very specific product. So on our product list, we can select from very specific products, or you can do specific collections. So let's say you have a huge collection of socks and you wanna leave it open for the customer to pick their style or type of sock that you want them to pick. So you would do specific collections, and then under collections, you would click on socks, for example. But for this example, I'm just gonna do products. So under products, I'm gonna search for bone. That's all we have in our store, so I don't have any other options. I'm gonna click on colorful bones. So if you buy colorful bones, you get one of a specific product. I'm gonna type in bone again, and you get a free dry bone. I'm gonna add that, and there we have the rule. So minimum quantity of items. You have to purchase one colorful bone in order to get one dry bone. And then you can also set up either a percentage, so you can do a discounted percentage for the dry bones, or you can just do free. That's what we're doing with this BOGO offer. Buy one, get one free. So once you do that, the next thing is the checkbox to set a maximum number of uses per order. So I would definitely check this if you don't want people exploiting that discount and using it multiple times. Once you check market, it will give you an option to select how many times they can use the discount per order. I'm just gonna hit one. And then customer eligibility, it gives you the ability to kind of be a little bit more granular and the type of customers that you wanna let use this discount code, but I'm just gonna leave it to everyone. And then usage limits, you can also limit it even further by doing a limit to one per customer, or limit the number of times the discount can be used in total. So maybe you have a BOGO offer and it's only for the first 100 people, for example, then you can checkmark the limit number of times and then do 100. So after 100 uses, the discount code is no longer bueno. All right. The last thing here that we have is active dates. So you can set up an active date when the actual discount code will be active on the store. And you can checkmark the set end date. So that will sort of have a cutoff date for that. Let's say if you didn't have the limit number of users, maybe you want to have the maybe for this month only, we're doing this discount. You can set the end date right there. So after you do all that, right here on the side, we'll give you a summary. So we have the BOGO 2020, buy one item, get one item free, one use per order. Anyone can use it, limit of 100, and active from today. After that, you just click save and you're up, good to go. Use the discount code. Now, if you don't want your customers to use and type in the BOGO 2020, then what you can do, I'm gonna hit cancel on this and discard changes. I'm gonna create an automatic discount code. So create discount, automatic discount. And then this one, you can name it the same thing, BOGO 2020, but the customers are not gonna type that in. Shopify is just gonna do it automatically for them, which is kind of nice. Again, depending on the items that you have and the products that you sell. So type, again, buy X, get Y. We're gonna do the exact same thing, specific product. We're gonna do bone, we're gonna do colorful bones, we're gonna add that, and then you get the dry bone. So I'm gonna type in dry. I'm gonna add that, and then I'm gonna do it for free. And I'm gonna limit it to one person, and I'm gonna click save. Now, be wary that automatic discounts, Shopify only allows you to have one active automatic discount. So if you already have something else that's automatic, and that's a discount and it's active, you cannot have two at the same time. So if you do have another one, it will give you a message saying, hey, you can't turn this on because you already have one automated discount on. So after that's done, that's it. You don't have to do anything else. Now, very important, in order for this discount to work, the customer has to put in those specific products in the cart. So I'm gonna show you how that looks. So I'm gonna go to our store, I'm gonna hit on catalog, and then I'm gonna add the colorful bones to the cart. Wait, actually, I might have it already. Yep, I do have it. So if I have my colorful bones in the cart and then I have my dry bones, then because I have the automatic discount set up, Shopify automatically gets rid of the $5 for the dry bones and it has the BOGO offer right there. So the only pricing for the checkout is the $12 for the colorful bones. Again, if this wasn't an automated discount, it will still have the same pricing in there. It wouldn't say anything about BOGO. The customer will have to know that there is a BOGO 2020 offer, and they would know that in the checkout page, that's where they would actually type in the BOGO 2020 in order to get that discount. Again, there's pros and cons to using the manual and the automatic. So again, it just depends on your store, but certain rules do apply. The customer needs to include those products in the cart for Shopify to actually click in and, you know, create the automatic discount. Otherwise, Shopify will not just add that free pair of socks, even if you have this particular item in your cart. So pay attention to that. All right, that's it for today. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and leave a comment down below. Let me know if you need any help with this video in particular, or if you want to maybe for me to do this, like another tutorial on maybe different types of discounts, or anything else regarding Shopify.